Hello everyone. Today we are going to deal with the microcontroller 8051. We have gone through 8085 microprocessor already. We will be going through what is a microcontroller. We will again go through the difference between microprocessor and microcontroller in this video, and we will study 8051 in detail here. So let's start. So the contents of this presentation are introduction, microcontroller versus microprocessor, then architecture of 8051, pin diagram of 8051, then pin configuration of different pins, memory organization and applications of 8051. So let's start with an introduction of a microcontroller. It's a single chip computer or a CPU with all peripherals like RAM, that is random access memory, ROM, that is read-only memory, I/O, that is input and output devices, timers, HD converters, etc. on the same chip. Or also we can say a microcontroller is meant to be a more self-contained and independent and functions as a tiny dedicated computer. So basically microcontroller will be a tiny computer or a dedicated computer for particular tasks. The different features of 8051 are: it is useful for small computing tasks. It's adequate for many control and monitoring applications. It has different packages like RAM, ROM, timers on chip. It consumes less power. It is easily upgradable. And cost per unit is less. These are few features of 8051. Let's go through the difference between microprocessor and a microcontroller. So basically, microprocessor is general purpose device while microcontroller is a single chip computer. Microprocessor doesn't contain on-chip input-output ports, timers, A/D converters or memory, etc. Microcontroller includes RAM, ROM, timers, ADCs, DACs, interrupts on-chip, on a single chip. Microprocessors are used as a CPU in computer, while microcontrollers perform control-oriented applications. Microprocessors are designed in a complex and expensive, that is, microprocessors are having the complex design and are expensive, while microcontrollers are simple and less expensive. For example, microprocessor, we all know, in a CPU of a computer, personal computer or a laptop, we can get a microprocessor major times of Intel family. We majority times use Intel family microprocessors like Core i3, Core i5, Core i7 are the microprocessors, latest microprocessors, which are in a computer. While microcontrollers are present in remote controllers of televisions or air conditioners, etc. So basically main difference is microprocessor can handle number of tasks at a time, while microcontroller are designed for specific tasks to be performed. So means we can start number of programs at the same time on a computer, like while typing any text in a Word file, we can side by side listen to the music on a music player in a laptop. So microprocessors are more multitasking, and microcontroller is for a specific task, like as I already said, a remote controller of a television or an air conditioner. It has few buttons, and that is the only functions available in a microcontroller. Okay, like on, off, change the channel, increase volume, decrease volume. So such specific operations will be performed by using a microcontroller. Even the keyboard of a computer again control is having a microcontroller. So the function of keyboard is only use of the keys. So likewise, this is the basic difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. So now you can get an idea where to use a microprocessor and where to use a microcontroller. So for a specific task, it's better to go for a microcontroller, as it is simple in construction as well as less expensive. Let's go through the architecture of 8051 here. As we have already gone through the point that 8051 microcontroller contains its own RAM, ROM, timers and input output ports on a single chip, which is not in the case of a microprocessor. So here this is the architecture of 8051. You can see here it is the CPU, that is central processing unit of a microcontroller, which is connected with this 4 KB ROM, 128 bytes RAM. This is read-only memory, this is random access memory. It has two timers, timer 0 and timer 1. Then it has input-output ports. So it has basically bi-directional ports. So four ports are there, P0, P1, P2 and P3. For input output connectivity. Then it has which are parallel ports, and then it has two serial ports, that is TXD and RXD. Then it has bus control, that is, you know, the connections between all these is through the data bus or address bus or control bus. So these all are connected through bus control. Then again, 8051 has its own interrupt control on chip. So external interrupts can be directly connected through microcontroller. And for the working of microcontroller, there is one oscillator is present. Okay, so we know excitation through external quartz crystal to achieve the working frequency of 8051. So this is the correction here. So this is quartz crystal connected through oscillator to a central processing unit of a 8051. Okay, so this is regarding the architecture of 8051. Let's go through the pin configuration or pin diagram of 8051 now. So 8051 basically has 40 pins. Okay, so we can have an idea here. So from 1 to 20 on one side and from 21 to 40 on the other side. So total 40 pins are available here, out of which we have already gone through that for input and output ports, there are total 4 pins, pin 0, pin 1, pin 2 and pin 3. So you can see here, so this is the pin 0. So actually it is an 8 bit data receiver. So here this pin 0 contains 8 pins. So this is pin 0 bit 0 to pin 0 bit 7, that is, these are the 8 bits available here. Then here it is pin 2 bit 0 to pin 2 bit 7. So these again are 8 bits available for input and output. Then pin 1 bit 0 to pin 1 bit 7, again these are the 8 bits. and pin 3 bit 0 to pin 3 bit 7. These are 8 bit. So total out of 40 pins, there are 32 pins. 8 4s are 32. So 32 pins are available for the connections of the input and output ports. Okay, so you can see here P0.0, P0.1, P0.2, P0.3, P0.4, P0.5, P0.6 and P0.7. So these are 8 pins, that is pin 0 and 8 bits. Again, in bracket it is mentioned as AD0 to AD7. It means these ports can be used as connections for address bus as well as data bus. Again, here pin 2 is also address AD8 to AD15, that is address 8 to address 15 or data 8 to data 15. So likewise, you can send 16 bit address or 16 bit data. So here again, pin 1 bit 0 to pin 1 bit 7 are specifically only for input and output ports. Those are not used for address as well as data. Then again, all the pins for P3.0 to P3.7 are having bifunctional pins. So you can see here pin 3.0 and pin 3.1 are TXD and RX, that is these are used as a serial ports. Then pin 3.2 is INT0, pin 3.3 is INT1, then pin 3.4 is T0, pin 3.5 is T1, pin 3.6 is WR, pin 3.7 is RD, then XTL2, XTL1 and ground. So these are total 20 pins on one side. Then on the another side, pin number 40 is VCC, that is we are going to supply positive supply voltage here at the pin number 40, and pin number 20 will be ground. So these are the two pins required for the connections to power supply. Then we are having some different pin configurations like EAVVP, then ALEPROG, then PSEN. What are the functions of these pins? We will go through those one by one. Then pin number 9 is a reset pin, that is RST. So it is very simple to go through these have an idea regarding these 40 pins. It can be directly represented while preparing for examination. Keep in mind. So what are the different functions of different pins? That we are going to study further. So let's go through the pin configuration. So different pins. So first is ALE or PROG. When this pin is high, it latches the low byte of the address during access to the external memory. This pin is low during EEPROM programming. That is the function of that pin. Then PSEN, that is program store enable. It reads is the read stroke to external program memory. Okay, so when this pin is high, it will read from external program memory. Then EAVVP, this pin is an active low pin connected to ground when microcontroller is accessing the program code stored in the external memory, and connected to VCC when it is accessing the program code which is in on chip memory. So that is the difference. So it is external enable, also it is called as external enable. Okay, then next RST. I already told you, applying a high pulse to this pin, the microcontroller will reset. It is the pin number 9 and terminate all the activities. Then port 0 to 3, as I told you, these are 8 bit bidirectional input output ports. Port 0 does not contain any internal pull-ups, and port 3 has alternate function. So those are bifunctional pins, RXD, TXT, INT0, INT1, T0, T1, read and write. Okay. XTL1 and XTL2 are the connections of oscillator for the working of microcontroller. As we have discussed, we need to supply working frequency through these two pins. VCC is supply voltage, VCC is circuit ground potential, that is ground. Okay, now let's go through the memory organization of 8051. As we know that microcontroller has its own memory on chip, so there are different memory types which are available on chip, that is code memory or ROM, external RAM, on chip ROM, internal RAM, then special function registers and machine cycle. Okay, so these are few points regarding the memory that we are going to go through. So here again we can see external RAM and external ROM can be connected to the microcontroller. So here it is internal RAM, specific function registers, and internal code, that is internal ROM. These are the components of a microcontroller memory. So code memory holds the actual 8051 program, limited to 64 KB, maybe both internal or external. Okay, then external RAM, slow accessing speed, it gains in quantity and limited to 64 KB. On chip memory, it refers to that memory which physically exists on a microcontroller chip itself. There are two types, internal RAM and special function registers. Total 256 bytes, equal memory of RAM and SFR, that is 128 bytes for both. Okay, so we can go through this again, elaborated view of a memory. So here you can see here it is internal RAM address from 00 to 30, and again to 7F, from 80 to here it is written 82, lastly it is FFH, here ATH to FFH. So these are different slots. So basically description is given here, there are four registers available. So register bank 0, 1, 2 and 3, likewise there are total four register banks are available, with each having 8 bit data to store. So from 00 to 07, okay, is the first register bank. Okay, and here you can store again 8 bit information in each section. Then register bank 1 is from 08 to 17, sorry, 0F, sorry, my mistake. So here it is 00 to 07, 08 to 0F, then 10 to 17, and 18 to 1F. So these are all in hexadecimal numbers. Keep in mind, hexadecimal digits are to be used here. Then 20 to here it is 27, then 28 to 2F, then 30 to 7F are used as general used RAM and stack space, which is 80 bytes. Okay, so these all total are actually, so from for register bank we need to go for 32 bytes. Okay, so 8 bytes for each into 4, that is 32 bytes. Then bits 00 to 3F and bits 40 to 7F, these are for again these are 16 bytes separately. Then these 80 bytes, and the last is a special function SFR. SFR is the remaining out of 128. So this is the bifurcation of a RAM, of a internal RAM, which is 128 bytes for a 8051 microcontroller. So that is the bifurcation: 32 bytes for register banks, then special purpose registers 80 bytes, okay, and 16 are SFR, 16 bytes are for special function registers. So total 128 bytes. Okay, then special function registers, what are those? Those are accumulator, then bit register, program status word, stack pointer, data pointer, ports 0 to 3, timer registers and control registers. These are special function registers. Okay, now we will go through the applications of 8051. There are lots of applications where nowadays we use different microcontrollers. Some basic applications we will go through, like automobile, then rail transport, industrial processing, remote sensing, robotics, consumer electronics, security, that is e-commerce and smart cards, medical, defense application. These are few applications. Okay, as for the mentioning here, I have mentioned few of them. So microcontrollers are largely used in nowadays. We are going for the automation and mechatronics thing. So basically, in each and every mechatronic component, we can see a microcontroller. Nowadays, there are lots of progress and updations are going on in microprocessors as well as microcontrollers. So 8051 is a very basic microcontroller. Okay, there are very new versions of microcontrollers are available nowadays. So this was regarding 8051. Thank you.